Hi, my name is Neftali Sillero. I'm going to present this work with the title Shifts in Climatic Realized Niches of Iberian Species. As you know, climate change has strong effects on biodiversity. One of these effects is that the species' geographical ranges shift in latitude or elevation while tracking their natural habitats. Here we have two hypotheses. One is that the realized niche of the species remains stable, and the geographical range shifts when the species is able to track its natural habitats. Or the geographical range remains stable and the realized niche of the species shifts through its fundamental niche when the species is not able to track its natural habitats. So we are going to analyze whether the species have already shifted their realized niches under current climatic conditions. We want to compare the climatic realized niche of 300 species selected from several groups of flora and fauna from the Iberian Peninsula between 2 years, 1979 and 2013, using the ECOSPAT-R package. As we don't have temporal series of species distribution data, because this data is not available, we are assuming that the species ranges remained unchanged during this period, between these 2 years. We used CELSA time series climatic data for the year 1979 and 2013. We used 300 species from vascular flora, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals. We calculated a Wilcoxon test to measure the differences in climate between the year 1979 and the year 2013 for each variable. We also calculated the Schoner's D index from ECOSPAT to measure the realized niche similarity for each species. And also from ECOSPAT, we calculated the stability and filling and expansion indexes to measure the realized niche overlap in the environmental space. And finally, we calculated the distance between the realized niche centroids. Effectively, the climate was different between 1979 and 2013. Basically, the climate variability reduces in 2013. Many species have shifted the realized niche to some degree. In fact, we have a gradient from very dissimilar to very similar niches, as you can see in the plot, for each of the taxonomical groups, from zero, that is very dissimilar, to one that is very similar niches. We can see the same gradient not only in the Schoner-Thies index, but also in the stability index, as you can see in the plot, in the expansion index, and the unfilling index. And also, we can see the same gradient from large to small distances between centroids, again, in each of the taxonomical groups. In fact, the species niches do not overlap perfectly over time, as you can see in these six examples. The stability area, that is the area in blue, doesn't occupy all the area of the species niche. We can see that you have green areas, that is the unfilling, sometimes even bigger than the stability area, and in some cases we have some small red areas corresponding to the expansion index. So we can conclude that in only 35 years the realized niches of some species started to shift. Thank you very much for your attention.